Santa Destroy is a magnet for the bizarre. There are things I still don't understand. It is a melting pot, not only of cultures and people, but even space and time. Did the hero survive? If you know, could you tell me?
You've got to be...
Mayday, mayday, mayday! Spaceship Vork to Mother! Do you copy? Please respond! Spaceship Vork to Mother! Looks like... I've been followed by an American? This is Captain Vladimir, entering emergency attack mode. Requesting backup for Vork! Transmitting present coordinates now!
Huh? Oh, fuck! What the hell? I gotta fight a whole fucking space program now?
Attack unsuccessful. Reacquire target and eliminate enemy.
Entering next level of battle mode! Awaiting response!
Awaiting response! Please respond! My ship.
It's over, Captain.
This is Earth?
Yeah. Welcome home.
So, I'm finally back. After all this time, fresh oxygen, blue sky, beautiful as I remember.
Glory to the Soviet Union.
You are now ranked third.
Just leave him alone. Let him rest in peace.
We must dispose of the remains. It's policy.
Screw your policy. He's back with the Earth after who knows how long. You're not gonna suck him up with your damn vacuum. Secret? I don't have time for guessing games.
It's the final Akashic point. Look for the hero's face. Sorry, that's all the information I have. Figure it out and get there.
Damn you.
You've heard about two of the supernatural gateways in Santa Destroy. The third led to the most fitting mystery of all for a city fixated on the ranks. Sealed from the cacophony of modern life, there lived the last ascetic. Abstaining from all worldly indulgences, the ascetic spent every waking hour in training. Battle had become an obsession for this warrior, the end-all, the raison d'être. You know I've never abstained from anything. Still, I can relate. When you're so focused on any goal, it can make you blind to what you truly desire.
Thank you.